Hey, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Andrea Coulter. I'm a doctor of medical alchemist and homeopathy and the founder of the IOMA Healing System, which you can check out in the links below. And today I thought I'd do something really fun and interesting because what I often find is taking responsibility for our health and our wellness and our life, sometimes it can be kind of boring. And so, we just try to ignore it and put it off. But I always try to find really interesting and fun ways to help my clients to maybe look at their life, but not feel like it's so overwhelming. So today we're going to look at how your car might be helping you unravel your own health. Okay, stick around and watch this video and see if you can recognize the signs that your vehicle might be giving you that relate to your own health. Remember, if you're ready to really take back your whole health care and to resolve your physical, mental, and emotional health all at once, be sure to ring the bell and subscribe and stick around because I put a video out every Tuesday and you're not going to want to miss one. So as you can guess, I'm one of those people who definitely looks at life as everything in and around me has meaning for me and has meaning for my life and my own soul spiritual growth and evolution. Now, I'm not saying that, you know, I go crazy with this and look at every little thing as, oh my God, that could be a sign. Oh, that could be a sign. Like yesterday I was in the barn and there was a weird toad in the barn. Never seen a toad in the barn before in my life. I could have went, maybe that's a sign and go try to figure out what it is. But no, I don't get that obsessed. We do need to live life forward and, you know, do what we can to the best of our ability. However, what I will say is that when something is blatantly coming at me and making me really recognize that it's affecting me, and the way to recognize that something is affecting you is if it stirs up your emotions, if you emotionally get caught up in some event or a word or a picture, then that has meaning for you. And then looking at what that emotion is welling up in you is your unique perspective, and it maybe is stirring up old unresolved issues that are yours. So I thought this week I would look at how something as basic as your car, your truck, your vehicle, whatever it is you drive, and if you don't drive a vehicle, maybe even look at the things that I'm going to suggest to you, but in other ways that you might recognize it in your life. So here are all the ways that I recognized how my car, when I've been driving it over the years, and I've been driving a really long time, but every time some fault comes up in my car or in relation to me driving, I started to really recognize how that might have some significant impact and meaning in my life because, well, it was affecting me. So number one is, if your check engine light comes on in your car, now it's not your car dies immediately, but even just the fact that your check engine light comes on and that warning sign hits you when you're driving, it might mean that, you know, there's something going on in your life that you're not paying attention to, that there's something in your life that you need to fix. And you really need to take stock and look at, what in my life am I ignoring that maybe I need to really be looking at that could make my life better? So I know the check engine light kind of is a, there's so many variables in our lives and what they could be, but I'm still saying, if your check engine light comes on, it's a sign. Take it as a sign and say, what in my life should I be fixing? Well, and or maybe you just need to fix your car, but also maybe use it as a way to recognize that, you know, the universe might be trying to tell me something. Number two is if you run out of gas. I don't know if this has ever happened to you. I mean, I realize that there's a gas station on every corner and we can fill up. But I'll tell you this, what's really funny is I've learned over the years to always keep my tank like half or above. Just because I grew up in the country and you just never knew when you were gonna come across a gas station. But the funniest thing is my husband always, his tank is almost on empty, all the time. And it makes me wonder, what could that mean? But if you are driving along and you've just been so distracted in life and you run out of gas, maybe it's trying to tell you that you are running on empty, that maybe you are doing too much in life. Maybe you've taken on too much and you're pushing yourself too hard and you're not being attentive. So now is the time to maybe stop and do a little self-care. So if you run out of gas, maybe think of it as, I think I need to stop and take care of myself right now. And number three is, if you ever found yourself just all of a sudden in the ditch, whether you've, you know, been distracted and hit the shoulder and veered off in the ditch or something right out in front of you or whatever, you're in a snowstorm and you slide off into the ditch, either way, if you end up in the ditch or in the rhubarb, as we call it, it might be a sign that your life is really out of control, that you have just been doing things that you should not be doing for your highest and best purpose. And life is telling you that you need to stop. You need to take stock on where you think you're going in life and maybe take a little more self-control and make some conscious, healthier choices. Number four is, maybe you run into random objects. So inanimate objects. You hit a corner of a building or another car, or you run into a grocery cart. I don't know. But if you run into something, maybe it's trying to tell you that you're not paying attention to where you're going in life. Maybe you are just unconsciously going through life and just letting it all unfold in whatever way it needs to for you. And, you know, sometimes it's okay. Sometimes it's great to just let life unfold. And maybe sometimes it's good to be in denial sometimes about what really is going on in your life. But if you're someone who just keeps running into random inanimate objects and your car has little dings and dents all over it, you might want to stop and go, I think I need to take a little more conscious control of my life. I need to recognize where I'm going in life. Because maybe I'm going in ways that I don't want to be going. And I need to maybe take a little more conscious self-control and in a healthier way. Maybe you've hit an animal. And this is definitely not fun. I've done this multiple times, which is really interesting over the years. And I will share with you this. What I often find when you actually hit something living is maybe you are being really unkind to the people in your life that you care about, or you're just being disrespectful to other people, to other things in life, other living things. Or maybe you're trying to derail somebody in your life and you maybe want to stop and think about how this is affecting them and in return how it's going to affect you in the long run. Also, and this is really random and weird, but I have noticed over the years, and it's happened at least four times in my life, and in over years, not just recently, but I used to notice that when I was driving along, and you know how birds kind of come up out of the ditch, they hit your windshield and they bounce off. I very rarely hit birds or have birds hit me, but I've noticed over the years that it became a pattern. And a pattern where if I started to recognize that in a short period of time I hit three birds in a row, within a 6-month period, somebody that I knew and loved passes away. And I don't mean to put this energy out there. However, I tried to not really get caught up in this, but I have noticed that it's happened four times in my life and several years apart. But if I hit more than one bird, if I hit three, I really start to be attentive to something really drastic is going to go on with somebody in my life. Now, it's not always been a person. I've actually had animals, like I had a horse break its leg and had to put it down. I know that sounds crazy, but there are signs and are all around us. And it's whether or not we want to pay attention to them. We don't have to. I couldn't control the fact that that animal or person was going to pass away. But it brought awareness to me so that I could cope better with it. Just something to think about. So comment below, have you ever had a car accident or incident that really made you stop and wonder, what does this mean? Why did this happen to me? If you have, share with me in the comments below. I'd like to know. Okay, so number six is a flat tire. You know, I'm sure we've all, if you've driven long enough, you've had a flat tire of some sort, and I have as well. Not very many, I think I've actually only had one flat tire. But this is when you're driving down the road and you just pop a tire. Generally, what this can mean is you could have a sudden loss of something in life, a loss of a job or a loss of a circumstance. Any kind of loss or change in situation in your life, you know, is possibly going on or coming up. And so it's just having you stop and look at the choices that you could be making in life and the choices that you have been making in life. And maybe there's something that you need to change or improve in your life to keep the momentum going forward in a positive way. So number seven is if someone hits your car, if you get into an accident where somebody comes at you and hits you, and there are multiple reasons for this one. So usually it's when you're in a really low negative mindset. And I'm gonna share this story with you. And I can't remember where I heard this. It was years ago I heard it, but it totally made sense for me. So think of it this way. You're driving down the road in your car, and maybe you've gotten up on the wrong side of the bed and you're just feeling crappy, or you're rushed. And it's interesting that I always tell my kids, never drive angry or rushed. If you are angry or rushed, you're more prone to getting into an accident. So think of it this way. You wake up, you're angry, you're frustrated, you're late for work, whatever it is, and you get in your car and you're like driving down the road, and you're like this, and somebody else is having a similar state of mind, and they're driving along this road, and you're going on this road. And the person in front of you, they're having a lovely old day, and they're like, la, 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 happily going along. So three cars on the road, this car that's in front of you, because they're in a higher vibrational energetic state, they zip through the intersection, and you two hit. Why? Because like attracts like. So energy states that are similar are always going to attract each other. So as I said, never drive in an angry, frustrated, or hurried state. Or if that's not the reason, then it could simply be that you just have a victimization state of mind or a fearful state that something bad is going to happen to you. And this is very, very common, because if you've ever had a traumatic car experience, then that memory stays within your body unless you resolve it with the IOMA remedy kits, which I'm going to talk about. But we always keep memory and cellular as well as energetic level memories. And so we keep that memory. If you know this, if you've had a bad car accident, you get in a car, every time you kind of see a car come at you, you tense and you panic. Why? Because that memory is there. And that memory can create further states. So if you've ever been in a car accident and you struggle with a state and you have PTSD, you might want to pick up one of my IOMI healing kits, which I'll have the links below, to help you free yourself of this state. Because they are designed to match that state, but with positive energy in a way that will help your body and life force push it out, because no two similar disease states can reside within the life force at one time. That's how these remedies work, by natural law. So definitely check them out. If you struggle with any of these weird states and they keep happening over and over and over, it's because you haven't released it and resolved it fully on every level. So I hope that these tips are kind of been fun and interesting for you, and it really made you kind of take stock and think, what else maybe is giving me a sign in life? If you have some other interesting ways that you actually recognize this is a sign and I need to pay attention, share with me in the links below. And remember, if you want a little bit more help with understanding states of mind, be sure to check out these videos over here. Why accidents happen to good people, and why this may be happening to you. So remember, for the rest of this week, be authentic, be empowered, and own it completely. Bye.